Hey, this is part two of my Tabula slash Google Sheets stock market analysis dashboard. In the first part one of the series, we use Google the Google Finance function of Google Sheets to download the three or four different stocks: IBM, Ford, Facebook, and was there somebody else? Apple. Anyway, three. Then we just did a simple plot of some of the variables. I think we did price and we did volume and maybe close also. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we'll come back and we're going to create a very common metric in stock market analysis, maybe even page one of your stock analysis book, and that is a moving average. Okay, and we're going to use this little video right here. And we do there's two steps. First, you create a parameter, then we use the window average to actually calculate past that average to the underneath. We're actually going to create two average fields because we may want to. You know, in one case, you may simply want to plot the moving average on top of another chart, or a more common thing to do is to actually use two moving average lines of two different lengths. Okay? So let's just come back. This is a very short video, so let's just come back over here. There will be a link in the video below to the moving to this to this. To this video. Okay, so let's try to create this first parameter. We're going to say parameter C. Integer, current value 1. Okay. Okay. Two, 30. Let's just start here. Minimum 2, maximum. Let's do 7. Okay, let's just copy this. Edit. Well, we're actually going to, we're going to do, first we're going to plot the moving average on top of this line here, okay? Then we're going to create a plot that contains two moving averages on top of each other, okay? So we got that. Okay, so it's the sum average. Of course, what do we actually want to do this on? That's the question. Let's start with closed. Okay. Okay, we got 1, 2. My guess is so you have 1, 2. Okay, right. Okay. So this is closed one. Okay. And let's duplicate this. Okay. So this would be for the second line. Okay. So now let's come up here. Let's do a new sheet. Let's do date. Let's do average. Okay, so this should be a moving average. Right. Well, the trouble is we don't know which Okay, we're getting really close here, I think. Okay. So Okay. So, this is okay. This doesn't look too bad, actually. Okay, so now we got the closing price, moving average. Okay, let's do this. Duplicate. Let's do volume. And that's okay. Let's just delete this. Let's just try this. Duplicate. All we have to do is Okay. So let's get rid of this. Get rid of this. Let's just do. Okay. Somehow, I thought somehow we had to. Let's check, make sure we haven't forgotten anything here yet. What we're looking for is where you put the synchronization, where you synchronize the two lines. Okay, so let's see what happens over here. Okay. Okay. That's not on the show. Close volume. Moving average to close volume. Let's come back. Let's edit this. This is moving average closed. We're actually interested in. Edit. Okay. 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 So we should be able to come back over even to here. Right? Plot. So we should be able to. Axis. Synchronize. Okay, let's go to this. Can we change the name here? Okay, so what have we added here? Let's get rid of four. Let's take a look at Google, see how Google's doing. Okay. Now we're getting somewhere. We actually have two different complete plots here. Okay. You got irregular plots, right? By stock type. We got a moving average plotted on top of a closing price. Then we got two moving averages plotted on top of it's great. How come that didn't do anything? Huh. Okay, that doesn't make any sense. Closing volume. 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 Okay, this current one here isn't working quite right because we got the moving average volumes, moving average two volume. And that's, of course, let's take a look at volume here, make sure they both do say volume. Okay, there's the problem right there. There. Okay. That's the problem. That's the problem. So this is a dual axis plot. We're plotting the moving average volume, moving average volume two different moving averages. Let's see something here. Let's come down here. And let's come up here. Probably a little bit too much. Okay, so this is the closing volume moving averages on top of each other. This is the closing price with two moving averages, daily volume, daily price. Okay, closing price, my price. You know, we could, of course, interesting enough, stack the two plots on two prices on top of each other. But we'll leave it like this for right now, okay? Let's do this. You know what? Let's see how long this has been. Okay. So that's in this section right here. Okay, we're actually really close to being where I want to be. The final phase, part three of this, will be the Japanese candlestick plot. So it'll be done from the video. Okay. Anyway, thanks so much for your time today. Let's go and upload this to the latest version up here. Let's go this, let's go forward. So this is a 51-day moving average. This is actually the let's come back over here. So let's do this. Let's do this a save as. So that concludes part two. We'll end this right here. At some point, you know, maybe after the third part, we'll go back and we'll start assembling. One thing I'm still looking for is how to pull down the Dow Jones, the indexes, Dow Jones, NASDAQ numbers down that. And the idea would be to create several dashboards. And then put together a story. We have one window maybe for the averages, and another window maybe have one page for, you know, one dashboard for just the NASDAQ, and one other for the Dow Jones stocks. Okay, but anyway, thanks so much for stopping by. We'll be back, you know, a day or so with part three.